हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल होम्योपैथिक नॉलेज। आई एम डॉक्टर श्वेताली। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द केंट फिलोसॉफी। लेक्चर नंबर 29, इडियोसिंक्रेसीज। सो दिस लेक्चर it deals with the examples of idiosyncrasies along with the definition and types of idiosyncrasies, which is given by Dr. Kent. So what do you mean by idiosyncrasy? Idiosyncrasy, it is basically the individual peculiarity of a person. Dr. Hahnemann has enlightened on this subject in paragraph 117 of Organon of Medicine. So idiosyncrasy means it is one of the type of oversensitiveness to one thing or few thing. किसी एक चीज़ के लिए या फिर कुछ चीज़ों के लिए ओवर सेंसिटिविटी पर्सन की we can term it as a idiosyncrasy. Generally some persons, otherwise they are healthy in their constitution, but certain things they affect these people very easily, whereas the same things do not affect other healthy people. Some people are susceptible and they are more immune. Idiosyncrasy, it is not a susceptibility that is seen in feeble constitutions. So for this, Dr. Kent has given examples of opium and quinine. For example, there is who is having chill and fever. So the primary action of quinine makes him alarmingly sick, whereas another individual may take 15 grains of quinine. So what will happen? The person who cannot take one quarter of grains without having overaction of that drug, it means he is having idiosyncrasy for that drug. The homeopath recognizes the wide range of susceptibility. Idiosyncrasy is oversensitiveness to certain things. So we can categorize idiosyncrasy into acute idiosyncrasies, which springs from acute miasm, and chronic idiosyncrasies, which springs from chronic miasms. Idiosyncrasies can also lead the physician to the remedy. Idiosyncrasy can be congenital or acquired also. I will give you another example of idiosyncrasy. For example, one person get very much disturbed or become sick due to the smell of roses. Roses are kept in somewhere in the house, and due to smell of that roses, that person, he will become sick. While other person, he will not have anything due to that roses. Use kuch bhi farak nahi padega. Roses ghar mein ho to bhi. Aur ek person ko, he will become sick due to the smell of that roses. So iska meaning kya hai? The person who will become sick due to the smell of roses, he is idiosyncratic for that smell of roses. Wo person us cheez ke liye idiosyncratic hai. So we can infer the patient's susceptibility to the remedy that will cure. The patient's sensitivity to the drug to cure him is analogous to the idiosyncrasy he has. पेशेंट की जो सेंसिटिविटी रहती है टुवर्ड्स द ड्रग, क्यूरेटिव ड्रग विच कैन हैव द कैपेबिलिटी ऑफ क्यूरिंग हिज डिसीज, इट इज एनालॉगस विद द इडियोसिंक्रेसी ऑफ दैट पर्सन। आई हैव टोल्ड यू बिफोर दैट इडियोसिंक्रेसीज इट इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स। फर्स्ट इज एक्वायर्ड इडियोसिंक्रेसी एंड सेकेंड इज इडियोसिंक्रेसीज दैट आर बॉर्न विद द पेशेंट, दैट मीन्स कंजेनाइटल इडियोसिंक्रेसीज। सो आउट ऑफ दिस two, the congenital idiosyncrasies and idiosyncrasies to the poison, they are very much difficult to cure. In congenital idiosyncrasy, from symptoms we can infer the remedy that can suit the problems. The medicine has to be given in a high potency. This medicine will not actually cure the patient. At the most, it could act as a palliative for few times. After that, the body becomes immune to this remedy and it will not act. sequelae are miasmatic. They are simply the outcroppings of the chronic miasm. Generally, the sequelae, they are always psoric in nature. The congenital idiosyncrasies, in such type of idiosyncrasies, the sensitiveness can only exist in the dynamic plane. There are persons in whom you will see the sensitiveness only when you go away from the plane of nutrition into the plane of dynamics. For example, here Dr. Kent has given the example of common salt, that some people craves for salt and eat a lot of salt. Here it is in the nutritive plane. This eating of more and more salt, it indicates that they are sick and need and they are in need of salt. But salt consumed in the nutritive plane. And this consumption of salt in the nutritive plane, it fails to save them. But the same salt in the high potency will reach his inner self and cure him. That means the remedy works on the dynamic plane. Where the disease is in the dynamic plane, the cure must also be in the dynamic plane. Agar koi bhi disease affect kar raha hai person ko, disease kahan pe affect karta hai? Disease will always affect the dynamic plane of a person. So, cure should also be in dynamic plane. Superficial cure agar hum log denge patient mein, to ideal cure kabhi bhi nahi milega. Homeopathicity is the relationship between homeopathic remedy and the patient who has been cured. A remedy appears to be similar before it cured. It is called the similimum once it has cured. Remedy ko hum similar kab bolte hai? Before giving it. Whenever we are finding out the symptomatically similar remedy, it is the similar remedy before it cured the disease condition. Once it has cured the disease condition, that means that remedy is similimum for your case. Further, here Dr. Kane given us about the crude poisons. The crude poisons in a nutritive plane, it is not very deep, more superficial, relates to more external things and to the body tissues. The same poison, when it is get potentized and taken in the dynamic plane, it runs much more deeper and last for lifetime of a person. But then this can occur only when the individual is susceptible. Ye sab cheeze kab ho sakti hai? Only when the individual is susceptible. Agar hum log crude poison ke baare mein sochenge, to crude poison kahan pe act hoga? It will act over the nutritive plane. It is not very deep. It is only superficially. Okay. It will relate to the more external things of the body and body tissues. But when that crude poison, the same poison get potentized and taken in the dynamic plane, it will run much more deeper form. And it will last, the effect of that potentized poison, it will last for lifetime of a person. But ye sab kab hoga? Only when the individual is susceptible. Some individuals are susceptible to all the things. And in their case, nothing can be exempted as non-poisonous. So these people, they are the idiosyncratic people. The susceptibility is the basic for contagion and the cure. The cause and the cure. Here the cause of sickness and the cure of disease condition, they are in the dynamic plane. When disease is in a primitive substance, the cure must also be in the same plane. Agar disease kisi primitive substance mein ho raha hai, to cure bhi hum logo ko wahi pe milni chahiye. Jaise disease hamesha dynamic plane pe affect karta hai person ko, to cure hume kahan milni chahiye? We should get the cure at dynamic plane. Poisons create disorders to the human economy or causes death. This applies both to the nutritive and dynamic planes. Man is protected from disease by homeopathy and its use. For the prevention of sickness in an epidemic, a remedy of less similitude is enough for protection from getting sick. So, in epidemic diseases also, we can use homeopathy, but in this case, we only need the less similitude medicine विच विल हैव द पावर ऑफ प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम गेटिंग सिक. सो लास्टली डॉक्टर किन टोल्ड अस दैट होम्योपैथी प्रोटेक्ट्स अस एंड ऑल्सो क्योर्स अस. होम्योपैथी हैज द कैपेसिटी टू प्रोटेक्ट अस एज वेल एज फॉर आवर क्योर ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज द एंड ऑफ द चैप्टर, एंड ऑफ द लेक्चर 29, इडियोसिंक्रेसीज. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस लेक्चर. And if you have any difficulty or any question regarding this chapter, you can comment below the video. Thank you for watching.